Welcome to Dev Delight, Development Done Right. And today we're going to be talking about the birth of JavaScript and ECMAScript. JavaScript was developed by Brendan. He was asked by the Netscape team to create a language that resembled Java for Netscape Navigator. He only had 10 days to develop it.
Being told to make it look like Java when I was doing JavaScript in 10 days.
Because Netscape was releasing a beta version, so he had to do it really quickly. He decided that Java is way too complicated, so he borrowed features from different languages to create JavaScript and make it simple. Netscape asked this company Sun to use Java as part of the JavaScript name as a marketing technique to attract other developers. However, to this day, JavaScript and Java gets confused by beginners and recruiters as being the same language or being related, and they're not. Mozilla is one of a few companies that has the license to use JavaScript name because they acquired the license a while ago. After Netscape released their browser along with JavaScript, soon followed Microsoft, and they created an implementation of JavaScript called JScript for their Internet Explorer. Internet Explorer eventually dominated the market, and Netscape unfortunately sank like Titanic. But right before, they created a standard called ECMAScript. ECMAScript is basically a standard that guides the JavaScript development. For a while, Internet Explorer dominated the market, and ECMAScript went up to version 3 and didn't change for a long time, for about 10 years. Eventually, Firefox and Chrome got developed, and ECMAScript gained momentum and started releasing new versions. ECMAScript is now a standard everyone is using and following. So that's the summary of how JavaScript and ECMAScript got developed. Please like the video, share, comment below, subscribe, and I'll see you soon.